In this section, we will discuss vulnerability to psychosis in 22q. We will begin by describing what are the symptoms of psychotic disorders, including both similarities and specificities in how these symptoms manifest in 22q. We will discuss the prevalence of psychosis in 22q with a focus on identifying developmental periods when vulnerability is highest. We will discuss clinical strategies and recommendations for evaluating risk of psychosis in 22q. Psychotic disorders are currently considered among the most complex forms of mental health problems. They can manifest with a combination of multiple different signs and symptoms. However, the hallmark of psychotic disorders is the presence of what are known as positive psychotic symptoms. These are symptoms that can cause an individual to progressively lose contact with reality. An example of psychotic symptoms are hallucinations, which are sensory experiences such as hearing, seeing, or even feeling things that do not actually exist. For instance, individuals with severe forms of psychosis will often describe hearing voices that speak to them and that they perceive as being hostile and distressing. Psychotic symptoms also include delusions, which are fixed ideas that the individual will have a very hard time changing despite being presented with evidence that they are not actually true. For instance, individuals can become convinced that strangers are conspiring against them and that, as a consequence, he or she is in danger. In the cases of full-blown psychotic disorders, such as schizophrenia, symptoms can cause patients to lose contact with reality, with a significant impact on behavior and on the ability to function in daily life. Finally, more severe forms of psychosis are characterized by disorganization of thought and behavior that can lead an individual to speak or behave in incoherent ways. Aside from hallucinations and delusions, patients suffering from psychosis often present other symptoms, such as a reduction in motivation towards activities that they previously enjoyed. Patients also describe a reduced ability to both experience and express their emotion. This combination of reduced expressiveness and reduced motivation is typically defined as negative symptoms of psychosis. Studies suggest that the clinical manifestations of psychosis are rather similar in 22q as what we described previously. However, some specificities of the 22q profile have emerged. In particular, individuals with 22q tend to present higher levels of negative symptoms, such as in particular a reduction in motivation towards social interactions. Negative symptoms strongly contribute to levels of functional impairment. However, unfortunately, they are also less responsive to current treatments that are otherwise very effective for treating psychotic symptoms. It is currently estimated that the risk for developing a psychotic disorder in an individual who does not have a 22q11 deletion is approximately 1 to 2%. This risk is, however, strongly increased in individuals with 22q. The most reliable estimates have been obtained by an international consortium of researchers who performed psychiatric assessments in over 1,400 individuals with 22q, coming from 15 different countries. Results indicated that among adults with 22q, the prevalence of psychotic disorders was between 30 and 40%. The same study also suggested that the prevalence of psychotic disorders strongly increases with age in 22q. Indeed, as you can see in this graph, the prevalence of psychosis was only approximately 2% among children, but increased to 10% among adolescents between 12 and 18, and to a further 23% among young adults. After the age of 25, the risk of psychosis remained relatively stable between 30 and 40%. These findings suggest that the transition between late adolescence and early adulthood is a critical period of vulnerability to psychosis in 22q. As we have seen in previous sections, such vulnerability to psychosis may be related to mechanisms of atypical brain development, specifically during adolescence. Numerous studies have demonstrated that an early intervention can make an extremely positive impact on clinical outcome of individuals suffering from psychosis. In this perspective, over the course of the last 20 years, researchers and clinicians have focused intensively on identifying risk factors for the development of psychotic disorders. This will allow to use earlier interventions that might be more effective or even in some cases prevent the emergence of psychosis. In this perspective, one of the most interesting findings has been that symptoms of psychotic disorders typically do not emerge from one day to the next. Psychotic disorders are indeed often preceded by milder symptoms, which can be detected through clinical interviews. For instance, before becoming convinced of hearing voices, individuals will often report milder forms of hallucinations, such as having the impression that they are being called by their name or hearing noises that other people don't hear. Similarly, before becoming convinced that strangers are plotting against them, individuals will often report feeling increasingly distrustful of others. Importantly, at this earlier stage, individuals attribute symptoms to changes in their own perception of reality. Although they have not yet lost contact with reality, these symptoms are still typically described as confusing and distressing. Moreover, studies have shown that the presence of such symptoms dramatically increases the risk of developing a more severe psychotic disorder in the next 1 or 2 years. Specifically, in 22q, studies show that such moderate psychotic symptoms might be present in up to 30 to 40% of individuals, in particular during adolescence. Among individuals who present such symptoms, approximately 25% will develop a full-blown psychotic disorder in the next 2 years. Among individuals who do not present such symptoms, development of psychosis was extremely rare. These results would suggest that a regular and systematic screening for the presence of psychotic symptoms can be an effective approach to predict the emergence of psychosis in 22q. Importantly, at this earlier stage, individuals do not typically share spontaneously these experiences with friends or family, often for fear of being stigmatized. However, a regular clinical assessment can identify individuals before they develop a psychotic disorder, and this can in turn open a wealth of opportunities for preventive intervention strategies. Although psychotic symptoms are the strongest risk factor for the development of a psychotic disorder, research suggests that additional risk factors also play an important role, specifically in 22q. One of the strongest independent predictors of vulnerability to psychosis is the presence of anxiety disorders. Indeed, some studies suggest that anxiety, which is extremely prevalent in 22q, can up to double the risk of psychosis. These findings are extremely relevant for clinical practice as they underscore the importance of a careful screening and aggressive clinical management of anxiety in 22q. Another warning sign that has been identified is a decline in cognitive functioning. Indeed, studies show that individuals who later develop a psychotic disorder have an early decline in their cognitive functioning, in particular involving verbal abilities. This finding suggests that an attentive follow-up of cognitive performance might be indicated in 22q. In particular, findings suggest that a decline of cognitive functioning that is unexplained should be a reason for an active screening of psychotic symptoms. In this section, we learned about the clinical manifestations of psychosis in 22q. In particular, we discussed the prevalence of psychotic disorders at different ages and how psychosis typically manifests in this population. We learned about the importance of a regular screening for the initial manifestations of psychosis, as well as additional risk factors that can moderate the risk for psychosis in this population. Current recommendations for the clinical management of psychosis in 22q will be presented in the following segment.